up, YouTube? It's your boy Double A, not Skills. And I know you're probably thinking there is no possible way, Skills, that you are coming to us in August with another GOAT, with another beast, with another amazing player that's unstoppable. Oh, and I am Booyah Nation. Welcome to the Rota for Champions RTG edition. We pick up Musa. And let me talk about something real quick, Booyah Nation. First of all, I have had an incredible, legit, an incredible start to the weekend. Like one of the best starts I've ever had. The only other start, yeah, that compares to the start I've had this weekend with this team is when I went 40-0. Legit is the only time that we're 20-0. We have a chance to go 40-0 on the road to glory, and it's literally because of Musa. And this to me is mind-blowing. It's absolutely insane. Now, listen, the only reason I picked up Musa, because Booyah Nation, back in like September when the game first released, when I was playing on my main account and I wasn't really showing YouTube what was happening, this was back when I was uploading just Draft to Glory. I wasn't really doing Rota for Champions yet. I was playing for Champions and playing my main account just on the low by myself. No one was really seeing the gameplay. It wasn't really going on YouTube. So I was running Sterling and Musa, and I used them to kind of build up my main account. And Musa and Sterling were amazing for me, yo. Before I found Sonaldo, it was all about Musa. Musa was my guy. Even when we started the Road to Glory, I'm pretty sure we used Musa. So last episode, you guys probably remember when I played with that Sterling card, I was dominating people with the Sterling card. And after I finished playing with Sterling, I told myself, I was like, man, you know, we're this late in FIFA. We're all the way in August, and Sterling is beasting and feasting on people. He's literally handing people L after L after he's literally on the field like, hey, hold this L for me, Ronaldo. He's just handing people L after L. So after I finished that live com in the last episode on the Road to Champions, I decided, you know what, I'm going to complete Musa. And I'm going to complete Musa because if Sterling is this overpowered, if Sterling is this amazing, what would Musa do right now with his footy card? And the reason I'm more putting this on the video is to let you guys know that if you want my opinion on when to complete Musa or not, I would say complete him, because as you guys can see in this gameplay right here and a lot of the gameplays you are going to watch, his speed is unstoppable. His shooting is it's bad. It's to the point where the thing about it is, you don't really need good shooting in this FIFA. You just need to know where to use the low driven from. That's the honest truth. I know you'll be like, Skills, that's BS. Yo, look, it doesn't matter if you got Ronaldo. It doesn't matter if you got Musa. It doesn't matter if you have Sterling. It doesn't matter if you have David Luiz. If you get in a certain position, you low driven for that shot or a low driven shot, it's going to be a goal. It doesn't matter who you have. There's just certain shots that are broken in this game and the keepers don't know how to save it. So with all that being said, who's a player that can get into great positions? Who's a player that can constantly get behind the defense, get behind that back line? You know, we put it on press back line, getting behind. We put it on that for a reason in our custom tactics. And the boy Musa is pressing the back line and getting in behind. And I know, like, a lot of people will be like, well, Skills, first of all, I am playing with a first-owned team. So the best we've ever done in the weekend league on this account was 14-0, and that's with mega teams. Not mega teams, a team we built on this Road to Glory. Now we're playing with a first-owned team, legit, straight-up first-owned. Every player was either, not packed, because we've never, well, packed out of rewards, or we did an SBC. Completely first-owned, and I'm just going to be 100% honest with you, being 20-0 is pretty remarkable. Now, I know a lot of people are like, yeah, Skills, it's August. Not a lot of people are playing as much anymore. Yeah, but a lot of the good players are still playing. For example, a lot of the pros are definitely still playing, because there's massive competition still going on. So there's a lot of players still playing, more of the casual Wolves have left. A lot of the hardcore players still play, which it makes a lot of good players still be out there. So we're 20-0, and I feel pretty happy with that. Now, am I going to finish 40-0? I mean, it would be an absolute awesome accomplishment to do on the Road to Glory account. I mean, that would just be insane to do. But realistically, I don't know if it's going to be possible. I mean, it's a first-owned team. I'm doing my best with it. If you don't remember what the first-owned team looks like, it's Red Alexandro at left back. It's Red Chiellini. It's Small Dini, the pink one. It's my right back is, who's my right back? Oh, yeah, we completed SBC, the Christmas Bellerin, that's our right back. And then in goal, we have the pink Butlin. And up top, it's literally Sonaldo, Musa, and Sterling. And Sterling is murking people. Him and Musa are actually outplaying Sonaldo right now, which is a mental thing to say. Look at Musa right here. You see what I'm saying? Press back line. That's his finishing. You saw that, right? That should have been a low drip. I actually placed that wrong, but that's his finishing. Most people would have finished that correctly. And then you get things like that. His finishing so bad that it hit the post and went in. He scored seven. Well, we scored seven. I believe Musa got like four goals in that game or something like that. But where I'm coming from with all this is that these cards, these Sterling and Musas are actually still dominating this late in FIFA. And it kind of just makes me sit down and just think about it all. Like, yo, when we switch our teams up to get these, you know, team of the year, Dembele, team of the year, this guy, team of the year, that guy. Although Dembele off the bench for me is, oh my gosh, we'll talk about that in a second. But you don't really need all these flashy cards at times, man. I mean, Musa's out here performing like an absolute beast. Now, obviously, this is not his regular card. It is his footy card. Sterling's purple card is dominating, and it dominated me all the way back in September, and it's still dominating in August. And I, like I said, trying to go 40-0 with this team is a little bit difficult, because when you build a team, this is the biggest thing. I got so many people tweeting me who are also doing the first own challenge, and they're saying they're not getting on well with their first own team. That's the problem with the first own teams, is that you don't have, because it's first own, you can't have the exact right player you want in every position. See, like, I wish we packed Nainggolan our rewards. I wish that we could have Nainggolan in this team, but unfortunately we can't. And if I did, I feel like this team would be so much better. Look at that finish from Sterling. I was actually shocked that he scored that, but Sterling scored one there, and then Sterling scores again. I mean, Sterling is scoring as much as like Ronaldo scored for us last weekend. Big boy, did we play with Ronaldo last weekend? We did, right? Yeah, we did. Big boy Musa finds the back of the net again, and I'll hit you with some stats. My man Musa has played 18 games and scored 22 goals and 15 assists, something like that. And I know you probably were expecting more goals like Alexis Sanchez was, but remember that this is a pretty cheap card to get to unlock. And to have 24 goals in 18 games with 15 assists, that means he's team playing well. And that's what the pace brings you. I always talk about this. Like, a lot of people look for shooting or passing or this and that. If you have a lot of pace and you can get in behind the defense, you'll create no matter what. Even if, like, he gets back there 10 times and he only creates right twice out of the 10 times, at least he's giving you 10 opportunities. We go down early in this one, but luckily this guy makes a mistake. Ronaldo swings it up to Sterling, who bags one into the back of the net. Musa and Sterling's shooting are both pretty bad, but they still get the job done. And when I say bad, I mean they're not as good as team of the season Dembele. They're not as good as Ronaldo, Messi, Suarez, but they're not supposed to be as good as them. We know that their shooting is not supposed to be as good as them. So, 8 minute, this is our ninth game of the episode right here. We go up against Tolo Slater. I've played this guy before. He's a good player. He has a really, really nice team, a rainbow team going on. The only regular card in there is Paul Pogba, which his regular card is good enough. Look at Dele Alli with a nice little step back, bangs it low, driven into the back of the net. Dele Alli gets the job done. Then here we clear the first one. The second one we cannot clear, and the game is tied up at one. As we proceed to go into this game, we swing it over to Musa, who doesn't miss from there. Big boy Musa makes it 2-1. Big goal for the man Musa. And I want to just clear this up really quickly. Khedira, nice job, man. I want to clear this up really quickly, is I know a lot of y'all gonna be like, but skills, man, again, no Lukaku again, you're not using Lukaku. It's weird for me, man. I know a lot of you guys want to see me play with Lukaku, and Lukaku does perform with me, for me. We've played him in last weekend and stuff like that. But it's something about having the pace to abuse. And a lot of people are like, well, skills, you're just a pace whore. It's not that, man. It's that pace is so important. Nice job, Khedira. Pace is so important in FIFA, man. It's such an important stat. It's been the most important stat for, you know, all the FIFAs pretty much. It's such an important stat. That when I saw Moose, I was like, let me just give him a go, man. Let me go back into the past and relive my days with Musa in September. Let's talk about Khedira, because as we talk about pace, let's talk about a player without pace. But I feel like in that position, it's okay to be lacking the pace. My boy Khedira is unbelievable. My favorite CDM in this game is Conte. I literally use him every weekend, no matter what. Top 100, everything, all my finishes, Conte's always right there by my side. He's my best friend, okay? In this game, he's my best friend. I love Conte. I try to build every team around Conte. He's my favorite. The only CDM that I've played with that has compared to Conte, it's this Khedira card. And I don't know what Khedira I have. I have the red one. I recently got him, I think. He is nasty. I don't know if that's a team of the season. I don't know what the hell it is, yo. I'll be honest with you. I have no idea what it is. All I know is I have Khedira. He linked up with Alessandro. He linked up with Chiellini. So I said, let me throw Khedira in this midfield. And he is an absolute animal. I know he's not the fastest. And I know it goes against what I just said about Musa. But you also remember the positions are different. Look at this right here. 9 games played, 13 goals, 8 assists is where it is. Just 9 games played with the team. That's what he was doing right there. So, but remember that having Khedira as a CDM with Conte covering for him, it's okay to be lack of pace. But when you have Moose up top, It's just, you know, he's the only guy. He's the guy that has to burn that back line, and center backs are hella quick right now. I know the next argument in the comments down below, but Seals, have you looked at Lukaku's team of the year or team of the season? That card is his team of the season. Not that he didn't get a team of the year. That card has a crazy amount of pace, and it does have a crazy amount of pace, but it doesn't feel as fast as beautiful goal for my boy Dembele saving the day. Oh, yeah, Dembele and Hazard came off the bench every single game. If you want to know what my super subs are, it's the purple Hazard, which we got from an SBC, and it's the team of the season Dembele that we got out of our rewards. So, just to let y'all know, it's first owned from the bench all the way up, except for the bronze cards. I'm not using those. So, yeah, man, with that being said, as I was saying, Musa is a guy that in that position, the striker position, for me, I need speed. In the midfield, man, I can deal with a couple slow players here and there because there's players to help out. Look at Ronaldo! When, you know, he's getting outdone by the boy Musa. He's getting outdone by the boy Sterling. He's like, wait, let me show you what I can still do. Nice goal from Ibrahimovic. That's another one. I would love to use Ibrahimovic. I thought thinking, like, Ibrahimovic on the team would be so much fun, but it's just like, as great as their finishing are, that lack of speed that they don't, like, I'd rather have a player that's fast with no finishing over a player with finishing and slow, because I'd rather be in the same position 10 times. You know, Ibro, yeah, you give him one shot, he's probably going to score it. I'd rather have Musa give me 10 attempts and only score in 10, but he just keeps creating because that gives me more opportunities to go sweaty on him. I could sweat it across for someone else to score, even if he doesn't have the best shot. Musa scores again. Look at Musa's finish right here. Nice over the nice little chip. And it's in the back of the net. We actually score another chip in this game. And in this episode, and it comes from Sterling, and it's probably one of the best chips I've scored all season on FIFA, man. But as you guys can see, we are proceeding deep into this. We're already past 10 wins. We're doing great. We're seeing great teams as well. It's not like we're coming up against cheese teams and we're dominating because of cheese teams. There's good teams in here, man. There's absolutely great teams. This game starts off with my boy Lukaku started this game. My boy Musa got an injury. He was going to miss one game. So I said, yo, if he's going to miss one game, let me run Lukaku. So I run Lukaku as a starter in this one. Dele Alli scores a goal right there, making it 2-0. Lukaku gets the start over Musa. Instead of buying a fitness card and wasting money, I was like, man, I got someone as good as Lukaku. Why not just start Lukaku? But it's crazy, right? Because the one game I start Lukaku, we were up 2-0. And then literally in like seconds, all of a sudden it's 2-2 and we go to extra time. But luckily, we are going to be able to pull this bad boy back, man. A nice steal from Kadira. Dembele missed the first one, but he does score the second one. We make it 3-2 in the second half of extra time, and that's enough to win it. But there you go. Lukaku started, and I almost messed it up. Not that Lukaku's bad or Lukaku doesn't get the job done. It simply could be I just don't fit his play style, because Lukaku does score a lot of goals when he plays for me. But a lot of times when I start him, it's really hard for me to get him going. Anyways, we are 13-0 as we come up against Suarez and Neymarzito, the new PSG, man. I reacted to that on my vlog channel. If y'all want to check that out, link down below. That's crazy. I can't believe that. I can't believe the money that's being spent in football right now. But my opponent was winning, but he makes a stupid mistake and threw it out too quickly. Ronaldo steals it, and he's trying to get us to 14-0. Kadira, Alexandro then clears it wrong. Kadira passed it to him. I passed it out wrong. It goes 2-1, and that goes right before halftime. Then we come out in the second half. My boy Dembele finds Hazard, who sends it up to Ronaldo. And I told you Dembele and Hazard would come in, and I would pull Sterling and Musa just so I could have better finishing. And look at Dembele handing us a victory, baby. This Dembele card's ridiculous. I know when I first bought him, remember, we bought him in this series, not as a red card when we packed him, but we bought him and we played him and I loved him. But it didn't really work out for me because I didn't like running a League One team or French players. And I didn't like that I was so like forced to have to do something to get him to work out. But yeah, anyways, he's fantastic. He's amazing for us off the bench. I don't know if y'all can see this right here, but I have a Band-Aid on my finger. Yo, this sucked. So last night I was 5-0. And also I want to let y'all know I'm 20-0. That's exactly where I'm at. But this is just like, it sucks so bad, man. I went up after being 5-0. I went upstairs and I was opening up. I was eating some cantaloupe, I think it's called. And I was cutting the cantaloupe and I was talking to Ray. And me and her are like going back and forth. I'm actually talking about YouTube and my vlog channel and stuff like that. And we're having a conversation. I'm like really into the conversation with her, and I'm cutting over the cantaloupe, and then bang, I hit my finger and this thing just started gushing blood, man. It looked so bad. And I was like, Ray, my finger. And then she kind of cleaned it up, and I came back down. I had to play yesterday and today because this happened last night. It still hurts like crazy and it's still bleeding. I didn't know if I needed stitches or not, so I just wrapped it up, and literally it hurts so much because you know when you're holding the controller, you're holding it like this, but the cut is literally like the whole finger. So when I push down, I feel like it's opening up and it just keeps bleeding. And I can't let it heal because I got to get the games done. But I went from 5-0 to 20-0. So I played 15 games still with the finger messed up and I was able to do all right. But I'm going to be honest with you, it hurts like crazy. Yo. Let me know the worst thing that's happened to you during a weekend league when you were doing good. Did you cut a finger? Did you get a blister? Something. Let me know something that happened. You break a controller by accident. You couldn't finish your games. Let me know in the comments down below. I'm 100% going to finish the games. I just didn't. It just hurts like crazy. So let me know one of your funny experiences because that's mine, man. I cut myself open eating some fruit and your boy had to play 15 games with a hurt finger. So this is probably one of the weakest teams we see in the weekend league when we get matched up against Korazma and Eto and Anthony Martial. It's a pretty weak team based off the fact that he doesn't have special cards. I wouldn't say it's weak because Anthony Martial is amazing. Sterling gets a steal, ball falls back to Musa, he tucks it, and that's a goal that goes in that realistically, guys, it's a bad shot from him. It was actually going out of bounds, but it's such a bad shot that it actually gave us a goal because that ball was completely off target, but luckily it hit the post. And that happens a lot when Musa hits the post and goes in. Sterling finds a second one, then we move on and to find a third. Nope, Ronaldo misses, it comes right back to us. I send it all the way up top to Sterling, who goes back to Ronaldo, who finally misses and gets a penalty though because the keeper ran into us, I guess. And I decide, you know what, I'm gonna give it to Musa because he deserves it. He's been playing good for us, but then I take it with Ronaldo, so I don't give it to Musa. And Ronaldo scores and it's 3-0. But I did give one to Musa in this episode. You guys probably already, you did already see it. So 3-0 victory. That is win number, I believe that's win number 15 or 16. We'll find out in just a second when it pops up on our screen. Oh, that's win number 17. So we're one win away from 18. We get matched up against a good team and a very, very good team, a good opponent. I actually think that's the same opponent that watches the channel that you remember when that whole thing went down where he didn't know and he was like, yo, he put me on Twitter saying, or on Reddit saying that, you know, I was supposed to be using my first own team and I switched, or my the pack only team, whatever it was, back when I was doing that set challenge. I think this is the same guy. I'm pretty sure this is the same guy, but I'm not exactly 100%. But either way, it was a great game. Regardless, 1-0 goes to 2-0. I think this is the guy. Don't quote me on that. I'm not exactly sure, but I feel like I remember that gamer tag for some reason. But either way, big boy Musa scores again, making it 2-0 against a good opponent, a tough game as well. Beautiful over the top. Look at Musa with the low. I tell you, I don't do nothing but low drivens with Musa. Then he finally gets a goal back right here with the boy Eriksen. Scores a nice one, and once he scored that, he kind of ran and shushed me and dabbed on me. So once I saw him doing that, I kind of just held the game. I passed it up to my attackers and I kept passing around in the front, and I was like, yo, if you're gonna dab and celebrate like that, your boy's gonna hold on to this game and make sure I get this dub. So that was win number 18 right there, I believe it was, as we jump into a team with team of the year, team of the seasons, birthday cards, footies. I mean, he has everything you can have, man, except for a team of the year. So that looked amazing, and a legend obviously as well. Nice header right there from my boy Smaldini, climbing the ladder, getting to the top floor and bagging one, and I dabbed on him by accident. Nice little pass right there to my boy Dembele, who bags one. Oh, that's Sterling, sorry, excuse me, 100% off right there. Boy Sterling bags one, Ronaldo finds one as well, and all of a sudden we're up 3-1. And yo, this is to my surprise, bros. I put a first own team together. I never thought it would do this good. Sterling, Musa, and Ronaldo are murdering people out here, and I hope I could just get top 100 for you guys again. We're in good shape right now, being 20-0. Best start on the weekend league RTG account. Nice chip over. He finds himself a goal, and he's shushing me as well. I guess the shushes are out tonight. I have no idea. That right there is 1-0. All right, we win that game 4-1, and we jump into what is going to be the last game of the episode. This is game number 20, and like I said, yo, I'm not caught up. I am one game ahead, and I can tell you I am 20-0. So I'm one game. I left one game out of this episode. It's not because I left out the episodes, because as I chopped it up before I commented, I was like, oh, I just want to play one more game. So I played one more game. So I'm 21-0, and that will be in the next episode of Road to Foot Champions. Look at that finish from my boy Musa again, and you just see Musa going off, man. I can't fake this stuff, bros. This is the weekend league. There's no place for me to fake it. Y'all are seeing the stats all in front of you. When I call somebody a GOAT, I know using the word GOAT is supposed to be grace of all time. Look, that's a chip from Sterling. That's such a sexy chip, man. I know the word GOAT. I use the word GOAT as if you were to just say beast. Moose is a beast, man. Moose is a fantastic beast. He's amazing. He's great. Y'all are seeing the stats develop right in front of your face. He's absolutely incredible for me, but he's always been good. I talked about this. Go back to episode 1 of the Road to Glory. I talked about Musa. Nice little goal. I defended it, but it fell to Lukaku, and he makes it 5-2 in this one. This guy actually makes a mean comeback. I was up 5-1, and he brings it all the way back to 5-4. Incredible, right? To when I had to finally switch my formation because he had me beat. And then once I switched my formation, luckily that ball falls to Ronaldo. We make it 6-4, and then we kind of go off right here. My boy Dembele looking for something, finds a shot, get a lucky goal, making it 7-4. And then we're going to put a little cherry on top of this cake to go 20. 20-0 as Sinaldo gets a rebound again. And we are now 20-0 with a first-owned team. The team is performing better than my freaking mega team, man. But it feels good. It feels good to be 20-0 on the road to glory. I've done 40-0 before on my main account, which qualified us for FIWC. It's been an awesome year for me on FIFA, man. And I hope you guys have been enjoying it. Thank you so much for watching this Road to Foot Champions. If you guys loving this episode still and liking it a lot, please smash a big old thumbs up. Crazy, man. Absolutely insane. 20-0. It feels absolutely great. And it's with this team right here that you're staring at. And there's Moussa stats. 18 games, 21 goals, 15 assists. So if I got those stats wrong during the commentary, I'm sorry. But his stats look absolutely incredible. Thank y'all for watching, man. Big thumbs up. Make sure to subscribe. Turn your bell on. I'm going to catch you guys later. You can watch my vlog channel down below if you want more of me. If you want. Only if you want. Peace. What's up, Booyah Nation? Welcome back to the Draft to Foot Champions. This is the series where we try to build through the draft to be able to play in the Foot Champions Weekend League. And as you guys probably know or you don't know, this is the last month of Foot Champions, which means it's perfect timing. We got to put a team together before the end of the Weekend League forever on FIFA 17 and try to compete at least one weekend and do the best possible. So right now, we have we put together a lot of coins. We've played in, I believe, 6 drafts. We won 5 of them and lost 1. I believe that's how it works out. I believe that's how the math works out. And the